transmission bandwidth of PCM signals. So let us start with assuming that we have a message signal m of t and it is band limited to b hertz, and the minimum sampling rate is 2b samples per second. So this is from the Nyquist criterion, that whatever the bandwidth of the message signal is, you multiply it by 2 to get the sampling frequency. So minimum sampling rate is 2b samples per second. So for an n bit quantizer, output analog to digital output is n bits per sample. So over here we can suggest that the capacity C is simply 2nb. That is, this n is coming from the quantizer, this is the bandwidth of the message signal, and this 2 is coming from the sampling frequency. Also, we note that the minimum channel bandwidth is bit rate by 2. Why is it so? This is because we have previously mentioned that for 1 hertz of a channel, what you can send is, you can send 2 bits per second. The transmission bandwidth, that is the bandwidth of the PCM signal under strict constraints, is BT is NB. So this means that you divide C by this 2 to get BT, right? So instead of having 2NB, now you have NB. The bandwidth of the transmitted signal for PCM requires that it should be greater than or equal to the number of bits times the bandwidth of the message signal. And hence, for any reasonable quantization level L, PCM requires much higher bandwidth than the original M of T. And it is dependent on the quantization levels L and the number of bits. So let us look into one example. So this example is taken from the textbook, that is from Lottie, and says that a signal M of T is band limited to 3 kilohertz, right? So we can say that the bandwidth of the message signal is simply 3 kilohertz. And then it says that it is sampled at a rate 33.33 higher than the Nyquist rate. So let us look into the Nyquist rate first. So the Nyquist rate, Rn, is simply 2 times B, and this would be 6 kilohertz. But it says that the actual rate is 33.33% higher than the Nyquist rate. So the actual rate or A is 33.33%. So this means that R n multiplied by 4/3, right? So this is going to give us 8 kilohertz, or simply 8000 samples per second. So our actual rate is higher than the Nyquist rate, which is desirable, right? So next it says that the maximum acceptable error in the sample amplitude is 0.5% of the peak amplitude. By this, what we mean is, again taking that example, and we say that this is our centroid, and so any values in this interval would be approximated to this one, and this interval is basically delta V, and over here we have delta V by 2. So the question states that a maximum acceptable error in the sample amplitude is 0.5% of the peak amplitude. So this means that this range, which is delta V by 2, should be 0.5%, that is 0.5/100 of the peak amplitude MP, right? So mathematically, this whole statement suggests this expression. But we also note that delta V by 2 is simply MP by L, right, in our previous discussion. So this means that if we equate these two equalities, this MP would cancel with this MP, and hence we can simply say that L is 100 divided by 0.5, which is equal to 200. So note that this L is simply quantization levels. But we know that the quantization levels are in terms of 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 2, 5, 6, and so on, depending on the number of bits, right? So it cannot take 200 as a value. So we can say that the desired quantization level is 256. So for this level, the number of bits that we require is n, which can be obtained by log 2 of l, and this is going to be simply, since we know that 2 raised to power 8 is 256, so log 2 of l would simply be 8 bits. So for an n bit quantizer operating at an actual rate which is higher than the Nyquist rate, the actual rate is 8 kilohertz, the capacity would be simply C, which is n times or a. So this is 64 kilobits per second. The question is, find the minimum channel bandwidth required to transmit the coded signal. And for that, we said that for 1 hertz, it can transmit 2 bits per second. Hence, the transmission bandwidth BT would simply be C by 2, and this is equivalent to 32 kilohertz. Hence, we have determined the minimum channel bandwidth required to transmit the coded signal. So for the second part B, it says that if 24 such channels are time division multiplexed, determine the minimum transmission bandwidth required to transmit the multiplexed signal. So for part B, when such multiplexing is done, we know that the capacity CM would be equal to 24, because there are 24 channels, times the original capacity C. So this means this is going to be 24 times 64k, and it is going to be 1.53 megabits per second, right? Hence, the transmission BT for 24 channels is going to be CM by 2, which is simply 0.768